daughter Kiddies, I'm Kerry, the vacuum tube witch, with the new intro, and the tube as always, almost always, and it's, I'm building time again. What am I gonna do now? Control assembly, and some wiring. Let's get to the bench. I will have to get something to put under the transformers before I can do any assembly work on the chassis. And those spongy thingies will be perfect for that. Let's start with finding the IEC socket for the mains. I got one from my friend because I just ran out of those sockets. That's strange, but I actually ran out of power sockets, so I will have to get damaged PC power supplies. Gotta be stuck on those. I mostly use second-hand parts. Can't always afford the new ones, and that's why new parts in my projects, they will be mainly the parts that I need to be reliable, like potentiometers and so on and so on. And the power connector, it can be second hand. Yes, I can start by attaching the socket. Gotta check if I have the conical head screws. Might be a little bit short. Yes, they are. I might go with regular ones. And this will be okay. Medical forceps, quite a nice tool for holding the nut in place. As I turn the screw with a screwdriver. And the other one. I could have made the secondary connections before I installed the power socket. But yeah, let's install them. Later on it will be a little bit more difficult, so I'd rather do it now. I discovered that if I put a piece of heat shrink tubing at on the end of the wire insulation and heat it up, like with a soldering iron, it will protect the plastic insulation from being melted as I soldered the wire. One is there. Oh, I might have cut the other one too short, or maybe not. And the other one. Ditch the band, make the end straight. And there is some maneuvering. And those two wires will go right to the rectifier tube. And now the power wiring. guess it's already shrinking. That will be fine. I will drill a hole for grounding the chassis. Or maybe I'll just use one of the existing bolts. I really think I should make a new one, like, somewhere around here. Yeah, let's do it like it should be done. So this will be the grounding point. I will deburr it. And yes, let's lead the cable all the way up here. I should have some soldering lugs. I should have them somewhere. Oh yeah. Now let's get a longer screw. And fasten this. So this is now installed. Let's clean this a little bit. Connect the mains. some insulation. Yeah, I will use a heat gun to shrink it even better, but for now, just to prevent it moving around, I will just use the iron. Oh, did I forget something important? I probably did. Of course, the main switch. And thinking of it now, I can twist those wires. As for the main switch, I've got a pretty small one, single fold, double throw. Where did I have it? So it's small enough to fit in mechanically into this pretty cramped space. I will have to check the on and off position. So the contact is opposite to the lever. It's a trans switch. And yet another brown piece of wire. to the transformer. And let's make the heat shrink tube cover both contacts. I will have to use a larger heat shrink tube. Even this one is a little bit too thin. And this might be the time to draw my gun. The thermal energy emitter device. So this wire will go to the left contact, this wire will go to the right contact. So the neutral is there. And now the life. I apply just a teeny tiny bit of solder to prevent the strands from fraying. Installing the main switch. Pulling the heat shrink tube as far back as I can so that it doesn't shrink all by itself when I solder the connection. Bending the wire. I need to flatten this. Tighter, tighter! Tighter than ever, Granger slices! One megum, and 250 kilos. If I remember correctly, it's the base pot that was. It was the treble pot that was 250 kilo. Where's the knot? And the remaining potentiometers. I've got two gain mentioned the chicken heads. Not sure if I should attach them now or later. This thing is starting to resemble an amp. So then there's the last part, there's the final switch. This switch will go here. And it will be used for selecting the tube or solid state rectifier. I will tell you about the idea behind the rectifier in the next video with a schematic and all that. I have enough clearance between the contacts on the tube socket. Wondering if those contacts are actually used. This is the EZ81 tube. And the contact number 8 and 9, they are not used. I might use them as terminals if I have to. Let's take a look at how it will look. That's how the chassis will look like with all the tubes installed. For the sake of completeness. With the effect loop sockets. I will have to get around to finding this. So that would be it for now for the DD12 Dirty Dozen amplifier build. I will take the tubes out. It will take me a lot of time before I complete the connection work. So, see you in the next one.